Welcome to the FixSleep Bedtime Stories Channel, your sanctuary for relaxation, meditation, and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this journey to relaxation. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our magical sleep stories. So, let the tale begin. The Enchanted Shirt. Chapter 1. The Gift of Power. In the verdant, sprawling landscape of Greenvale, nestled between the towering, whispering woods and the rushing River Timor, lived Cael, a young man of modest means but unparalleled valor. His days were filled with the toil of the fields and the care of his aging parents, his nights with dreams of adventure and deeds of daring. Though he wore the simple garb of a peasant, his demeanor was that of an undiscovered hero. One fateful evening, Cael chose a less traveled route through the whispering woods as the sun sank below the horizon, transforming the sky into shades of deep purple and blazing orange. Spirits were thought to reside there, keeping watch over long-kept secrets and directing the paths of anyone brave enough to venture within. Cael's life was about to change that night, turning him from a young boy from the hamlet into a legendary person. As he meandered through the dense underbrush, the light fading with each step, a sudden cry for help pierced the twilight. Following the sound, he came upon an old woman trapped under a fallen, gnarled oak branch. This was no ordinary woman, but Morna, the village's reclusive witch, known equally for her healing potions and her mercurial temper. Without a second thought for his own safety, or the rumors that often surrounded Morna, Cael rushed to her aid. With considerable effort and the adrenaline that one finds in moments of crisis, he managed to lift the branch just enough for Morna to free herself. As she rose, brushing dirt from her robes, her eyes gleamed with a mix of surprise and profound gratitude. "Brave heart," Morna said, her voice a raspy whisper that seemed to blend with the rustling leaves. "You have shown kindness and courage, qualities that are rare, and thus all the more valuable. I must repay you, for such deeds deserve reward beyond mere words." Before Cael could protest, Morna beckoned him to follow her to her cottage, a peculiar structure woven between two ancient cedars. Inside, the air was thick with the scent of herbs and the smoke of incense. The walls were lined with jars of peculiar powders and liquids that bubbled and shimmered in the firelight. From a chest carved with runes and symbols that seemed to dance in the flickering light, Morna retrieved a garment folded neatly, its fabric shimmering with an ethereal glow. "This," she declared, "is the enchanted shirt, woven from the threads of moonlight and the essence of shadows. To the wearer, it grants strength beyond measure and the power to evade sight, the blend of might and mystery." Cael, overwhelmed by the gravity of the gift, felt a surge of destiny. The enchanted shirt felt cool and light as air as he took it in his hands. Morna's eyes twinkled as she spoke the incantation that would bind the shirt's magic to Cael. Words of old, powerful, and solemn filled the room, enveloping Cael in a wind that whispered of ancient battles and promises of untold adventures. "Use these gifts wisely," Morna advised as the ritual concluded. Great power is a great burden, but I sense that your heart is true and your spirit is bold. Empowered by the enchanted shirt, Cael left the witch's cottage with a new sense of purpose. As he stepped back into the night, the world seemed different, more vivid, alive with possibilities. He could feel the strength coursing through his veins, and when he willed it, his body melded with the night, rendering him invisible to the naked eye. Over the following days, Cael tested his new abilities, marveling at the strength that allowed him to uproot ancient stumps, and the stealth that made him unseen, even in the bright light of day. But such power did not go unnoticed. Rumors began to swirl in Greenvale, whispers of a young man with the strength of 10 and the ghostly ability to vanish into thin air. It was during this time of wonder and wary glances that a royal decree was posted in the village square, its seal marked by the king's own hand. The princess had been captured by a fearsome dragon, and the king called for heroes to attempt her rescue. The reward was beyond imagination: the hand of the princess and half the kingdom. Cael knew this was the moment his destiny had awaited. Clad in the enchanted shirt, he felt ready to face whatever perils lay ahead. He was no longer just Cael, the farmer's son. He was Cael, the bearer of enchanted power and a burgeoning hero. With a resolve as sturdy as the earth beneath his feet and a heart as fiery as the setting sun, he set out to rescue the princess and perhaps find his place in the annals of legend. Chapter 2. The Journey Begins. As the first light of dawn stretched its fingers across the landscape of Greenvale, Cael prepared for the journey that lay ahead. With the enchanted shirt cloaked beneath his tunic, he felt every inch the hero he hoped to become. Endowed with powers that once belonged only in the tales told by the village elders. This morning, however, he was not just a character in a story. He was the protagonist of his own epic saga. Cael's journey began at the edge of Greenvale, where the cobblestone paths gave way to the wild, untamed roads that snaked through the kingdom. His first destination was the Whispering Woods, a vast forest so named for the way the wind seemed to murmur through the ancient trees, carrying secrets of old. Legend had it that the woods were alive, sentient in a way that only the most attuned traveler could sense. It was said that the trees could either guide one's way or lead one astray, depending on the traveler's heart and purpose. As Cael entered the forest, the canopy above swallowed the light, creating a dim, verdant world beneath. He could hear the faint whispers around him, gentle murmurs that seemed to evaluate his presence. Trusting in the magic of the enchanted shirt, Cael proceeded, his steps silent, and his eyes keenly observing the shifting shadows and the faint paths that offered themselves to him. It wasn't long before Cael encountered his first trial. A river, swollen with the recent rains, blocked his path, its waters rushing dangerously fast. Here, Cael tested the strength granted by the shirt, gathering large stones and fallen logs to create a makeshift bridge. With each boulder he lifted, which would normally require 3 men to move, he marveled at his newfound strength, a tangible confirmation of Morna's gift. Once across, Cael ventured deeper into the woods. Here, he met a creature of lore, a wizened old tortoise with a shell coated in runes. The tortoise, recognizing the aura of the shirt, offered Cael a challenge of wit to solve a riddle that would ensure his safe passage through the forest. I speak without a mouth, and hear without ears. I have no body, but I come alive with wind. What am I? It asked, in a slow, gravelly voice. Cael pondered the question, his mind weaving through possibilities. Finally, understanding dawned, and he replied, "You are an echo." Pleased with his answer, the tortoise nodded slowly, its eyes twinkling with a sage light. "You have the wisdom to match your strength, young hero. Proceed with both, and you may yet save your princess," it said, before ambling off into the underbrush. With the tortoise's blessing, Cael continued on, the woods gradually opening up to the vast, sweeping sands of time. This desert was another realm altogether, where the ground shifted beneath one's feet, and the horizons were ever elusive. It was here that Cael's power of invisibility would be tested against the desert spirits that roamed the dunes. Creatures made of sand and wind, jealous of any who dared cross their barren lands. As the spirits swirled around him, their forms shifting and treacherous, Cael used the shirt's magic to blend into the landscape, becoming unseen as he maneuvered through the sands. He watched as the spirits searched, their frustration evident as they failed to locate him. Using this advantage, Cael hastened across the desert, each step bringing him closer to the Mountains of Echoes, his final barrier before reaching the dragon's lair. The mountains were a stark contrast to the desert he had just crossed. Here, the air was crisp, and the sounds of his movements echoed between the high peaks, returning to him distorted and strange. The mountains demanded respect, their sheer cliffs and hidden crevices a test of both his physical agility and his mental resolve. Yet, with each echoed step, Cael grew more attuned to the rhythm of the mountain, using the echoes to guide his ascent rather than confuse his path. By nightfall, Cael reached the summit of the tallest peak, where the air was thin and the view stretched across the kingdom. Here, he set up a small camp, the stars his only canopy. As he gazed out over the land, his heart swelling with the beauty and the challenge of it all, he felt a deep, unshakable conviction in his mission. Tomorrow, he would descend into the dragon's domain, armed with the strength, stealth, and wisdom he had honed on his journey. Thus, under the watchful eyes of the stars, Cael rested, the enchanted shirt his silent sentinel, ready for the final leg of his quest to rescue the princess and confront the dragon that awaited him in the shadows of the unknown. Chapter 3, The Dragon's Lair. As dawn broke over the Mountains of Echoes, casting long shadows and bathing the peaks in a golden light, Cael prepared for the most perilous part of his journey. Today, he would venture into the dragon's lair, a place shrouded in myth and woven with the threads of countless tales of bravery and catastrophe. His heart pounded with a mixture of dread and determination as he contemplated the challenge ahead. Descending from the mountain's summit, Cael entered the Valley of Shadows, the reputed domain of the dragon. The valley was a stark landscape of volcanic rock and ashen fields, where no life seemed to flourish. Plumes of smoke curled up from fissures in the ground, and the air was tinged with the scent of sulfur. It was here, in this forsaken place, that the dragon, known as Svarog, the Fire-hearted, had made its home. Cael's enchanted shirt shimmered gently, its power strengthening his determination as he drew closer to the dragon's den entrance. A large cave mouth guarded by statues of ancient warriors, long petrified to stone by the dragon's scorching breath. He could sense the power of the shirt pulsing through him, sharpening his innate senses and preparing him for fight. Taking a deep breath, he went into the shadows and used the shirt's invisibility to blend into the background. Inside the cave, the air grew hotter, and the narrow passageways opened into a massive cavern, illuminated by the eerie glow of molten lava that flowed in channels along the floor. The walls were lined with treasures from ages past. Gold piled high, jewels scattered carelessly, remnants of armor and weapons, all testimony to the dragon's long reign of terror. There, atop a mound of gold, lay the dragon's Svarog, its scales a tapestry of crimson and black, its eyes closed as if in slumber. Beside it, chained to a jagged rock, was Princess Eliana. Her gown tattered, her face smeared with soot, but her eyes alight with the fire of unyielded spirit. Seeing her, Cael's purpose solidified into a sharp point of clarity. He could not. He would not fail. Using the stealth afforded by the enchanted shirt, Cael navigated the treasure-strewn floor, avoiding the clink of gold or the clatter of loose stones. Reaching the princess, he whispered a quiet greeting, introducing himself as her rescuer. Eliana's relief was palpable, though she warned him that the dragon, though appearing to sleep, was ever vigilant, and any attempt to free her might awaken it. Cael, mindful of the princess's warning, carefully began picking the lock on her chains with a small tool he had fashioned during his journey. Each click of the mechanism seemed to echo thunderously in the cavern, and he paused with every sound, holding his breath, feeling the shirt's magic pulse in response to his heightened stress. Just as he unlocked the chains, a deep, rumbling growl filled the cavern. Svarog was awake. The dragon lifted its massive head, its eyes glowing like coals. With a roar that shook the cavern, it lunged at the source of the noise, straight toward Cael and Eliana. Cael reacted instinctively, pulling the princess behind a large boulder as flames cascaded where they had stood moments before. The enchanted shirt protected them from being seen, but not from the searing heat of the dragon's breath. Knowing they could not hide forever, Cael devised a quick plan. He instructed Eliana to run towards the cave entrance at his signal, while he would draw the dragon's attention and use his superhuman strength to topple a nearby pillar, hoping to momentarily trap the beast under debris. The plan was risky, but it was their only chance. As Eliana sprinted towards safety, Cael dashed across the cavern, visible now, taunting the dragon to chase him. Svarog, enraged, pursued, breathing fire, and thrashing its mighty tail. At the right moment, Cael used all the strength granted by his enchanted shirt to push over the pillar, sending rocks crashing down onto Svarog. The dragon was pinned, roaring in frustration and pain. Seizing the moment, Cael rushed back to Eliana, leading her out of the cavern as the entire structure began to shake, stones falling as the dragon struggled to free itself. Emerging into the daylight, their bodies scorched and clothes singed, Cael and Eliana looked back at the collapsing entrance of the lair. They had escaped with their lives. The princess was free, and the kingdom would soon be rid of its fiery scourge. As they made their way back toward civilization, their hearts were heavy with the cost of their ordeal, but light with the promise of freedom and new beginnings. Chapter 4, Triumph and Reward. After their harrowing escape from the dragon's lair, Cael and Princess Eliana journeyed back to the kingdom of Eldoria, their spirits buoyed by the success of their mission. The journey home was less perilous than their venture out, but each step they took was heavy with the weight of the trials they had overcome. The land itself seemed to recognize their valor, with the whispering woods quiet and the rivers of reflection flowing peacefully as if in honor of their return. As they approached the outskirts of the kingdom, the news of their triumph had already spread like wildfire through the villages and towns. Banners flew from every window, and flowers lined the roads, thrown by adoring citizens eager to catch a glimpse of the young hero and the rescued princess. By the time they reached the capital, a full procession awaited them, complete with musicians, dancers, and courtiers dressed in their finest attire. King Ivar himself met them at the palace gates, his eyes glistening with unshed tears as he embraced his daughter and then turned to Cael. In a voice thick with emotion, the king addressed him. "You have done a service to the crown and to the heart of a father that I can never repay. You have not only saved my beloved daughter, but have also rid our lands of a terror that darkened our skies for too long." The king then led them into the grand hall, where the kingdom's nobles and influential figures had gathered. The hall was resplendent with golden banners and floral garlands, reflecting the golden light from the massive chandeliers above. At the center of the hall, a throne had been placed beside the king's, a symbol of the honor that was to be bestowed upon Cael. "Kneel," King Ivar commanded, his voice now steady and regal. As Cael knelt, the king drew his sword and touched it lightly to Kyle's shoulders. "I hereby knight you, Sir Cael, protector of Eldoria, guardian of the realm, and defender of the crown. Rise, not as a subject, but as a hero of this kingdom." As Cael stood, the crowd erupted into applause, the sound echoing off the high vaulted ceilings of the hall. But the rewards did not end with titles and applause. Turning towards his daughter, the king took her hand and placed it in Cael's. "With the power vested in me, and with the full approval of my heart, I also grant you the hand of Princess Eliana, with her willing consent, and half of the kingdom to rule by her side." Princess Eliana, her face radiant with joy and pride, smiled at Cael. Her voice, when she spoke, carried through the hall, clear and strong. "This union, forged in adversity and triumph, is one I embrace wholeheartedly. For in Cael, I have found not just a rescuer, but a true partner, a comrade in arms, and a companion of my heart." The celebrations that followed were legendary, lasting 7 days and 7 nights. Minstrels sang of Cael's bravery and the dragon's defeat. Dancers reenacted their perilous journey through interpretive performances, and poets recited new verses composed in honor of their triumph. Feasts were held each night, with toasts made to the health and happiness of the newly betrothed couple and the prosperity of Eldoria. In the midst of this revelry, Cael and Eliana often stole moments for themselves, walking through the palace gardens or watching the stars from the balconies of the castle. They spoke of plans for the future, of the kind of rulers they wanted to be, and the legacy they hoped to leave. Their love, rooted in mutual respect and forged in shared danger, grew with each passing day, promising a reign that would be remembered as much for its wisdom and compassion as for its courage and strength. Thus, the tale of Cael, the once humble villager who became a knight, a prince, and a beloved hero, was woven into the fabric of Eldoria's history. It was a tale that would be told for generations, a reminder of the power of courage, the importance of resilience, and the enduring strength of love. The enchanted shirt, now a symbol of Cael's journey and transformation, was carefully preserved, a relic of magic and a testament to the fact that even the most ordinary among us can achieve the extraordinary, guided by the heart and fortified by faith.